Hello, hello, and welcome back for another fearsome fusillade of alien action as the three amigos, Johnny Rico, Dina Dizzy Meyer, and Jake Busey return to the battlefield to eat bugs for lunch in Perfidious Pete Plays XCOM 2. And seriously, guys, I mean, I know our little mobile infantry campaign may not be going that well and that by and large supplies are relatively low because I spent a whole bunch of them buying a new scientist to help Dr. Tigan with his corpse fiddling, but you don't have to eat bugs for lunch, guys. You don't have to do that. We have food. Sure, supplies are low, admittedly, but MREs are not amongst those supplies. I mean, we have crates and crates of those downstairs in the commissary. You don't have to go all Snowpiercer on the pressed cricket protein bars. Just telling you. Also, if you guys keep eating those pressed cricket protein bars, you're really gonna piss off Bradford. He's been trying for weeks now to perfect his recipe for John Central Bradford's cricket lick it cricket liquor. And if you keep eating his cricket mash, he's gonna stab you in the neck with a broken whiskey bottle. The man has a dream of opening a distillery once this whole alien conflict thing has been resolved. And if you eat his cricket mash, you're shitting on his dream. And he'll cut you, man. He'll just smash a bottle right over the bar and he'll come at you in a Wolverine berserk fury. So please, guys, just stop eating bugs. It's fine. We have food. I know some of the varieties of MRE are borderline inedible, especially the chicken enchilada. You may want to avoid that, but you know, it's food. It's better than crickets, right? After our recent success, members of the resistance in the eastern U.S. have brought us reports of activity. You're right, I do want to investigate that. If it has supplies, let's go there. We can avoid chowing down on crickets. That seems lovely. Let's do that. So, 7 days, yes. All right, let's just start scanning here. Oh, God. It's going to be Optimus Prime, isn't it? God damn you, Bradford. You ambushing son of a bitch. Yeah, it's Optimus Prime, alright.
Hello, Commander.
Yeah, what a surprise.
It would seem your recent activities have gotten Advent's attention. Our unwelcome guests are on the move.
You know, can you still call them guests at this point, Optimus Prime? I mean, they've been here for 20 years. At this point, I don't really think they're guests. I think they just live here. If somebody moves into your house and they stay for 20 years, they're not a guest, they just moved in.
A single word that appears in all their files. Avatar.
So maybe they're huge James Cameron fans. What's wrong with that? I mean, I thought Avatar kind of sucked, personally. Thought the plot was weak as shit, and the unobtainium thing was, too self-aware and clever to actually be good. And the whole we rape the environment kind of message, and I'm not talking about, like, abusing the environment. I'm talking, like, literally having sex with animals with your ponytail thing. Kind of turned me off on the whole story, but I mean, the film was visually beautiful. Maybe the aliens are just into that. Maybe they like the effects.
Direct approach. Though we may not know the exact nature of this Avatar project, we can still disrupt it.
Mm-hmm. Much like you're disrupting what I was doing right now.
With the help of local resistance cells, disrupt our enemy's operations, and in the process, uncover the truth.
So basically the goal of any guerrilla organization is what you're encouraging us to do, is just behave like a guerrilla group.
The enemy to succeed in their efforts, I am certain.
Yeah, you know, the only enemy to succeeding in our efforts right now is you, Optimus Prime. You're sort of a cutting off the nose to spite your face kind of thing going on right now. Which is weird, because given what I've seen of you, you may not have either a nose or a face. So cutting off your nose to spite your face is really a bit of a reach for you. So the Avatar Project, location unknown. So we just stuck the marker conveniently out in the Pacific by Hawaii. It seems like a logical place to put it, I guess. I just tried this and I'm surprised that it worked, but zooming the map out is totally something we can actually do. I really like that. So let's get back to what we were doing, which is this service depot scan for supplies, because we really need them.
This research can only further our advances, Commander.
Advent trooper autopsy. Research complete. All right, good. So Dr. Tigan is done humping this trooper's corpse. Let's see what he learned.
I have yet to discover what, if any, advantage the Advent
hybrid. Ooh, battle scanner. So yeah, this was definitely a solid investment of our time if it gave us a battle scanner. That's real good. Real good. So we got to build a battle scanner then. We also got to give you new research, right, Dr. Tigan? Extra vision soldiers play it like a grenade, throwing it to a hidden area of the map that they want to reveal. Any hidden or disguised enemies will be revealed as well. Amazing. Sectoid autopsy is now instant. Sectoid, given our extensive battlefield experience against the sectoid autopsy can now be completed. Oh, wow, that's a really awesome mechanic. Because we haven't bothered to do the autopsy, we've killed so many sectoids that now we can just... Oh, that's really awesome. Though that's fantastic, guys. Well done, 2K. That's a brilliant mechanic right there. Existence
of a much smaller, less intimidating variant of the sectoid that took part in the original invasion.
I don't know. Those guys killed some people.
This new being, the product of clear genetic manipulation, is now a familiar face to our forces operating in the field.
Yeah, and your continual raw dogging of these aliens with, like, minimal protection, Dr. Tigan. Every time I'm exposed to you, the level of your perv swerve just goes deeper and deeper down a rabbit hole, doesn't it? So, new item available, Mind Shield. New research available, Psionics. Codename Kexberg. I mean, sure, that's sensible. Alright, well, let's give Dr. Tigan a new task. The Mind Shield is a powerful psionic artifact rendering soldiers completely immune to any negative mental conditions, including panic, mind control, stuns, and disorient. That seems real good as well. So we gotta give Dr. Tigan a new task. This alien data cache, I really am interested in what this does, but unfortunately, I think it's probably just gonna give us intel. And I don't know what intel is technically used for, and we have a bunch of it. What I really want is more powerful. You know what? Screw it. I'm just going for the magnetic weapons. We need better guns on the field. We got to get better guns. We got to do it. So scientists, research, yeah, blah, blah, blah. Okay.
Dr. Shen's constant vigil over my activities is starting to wear thin. I consider myself a patient man.
Really, are we going with this trope again? The science guy and the engineer don't fucking get along. I mean, Dr. Valen and the original Dr. Shen sort of really took this to its ultimate extreme. Could we just maybe, like, kiss and make up? I mean, shit, Lily's sort of hot, Dr. Tigan, and I mean, I know you're more into corpses, but maybe a more conventional romantic relationship is worth exploring, perhaps? Call me crazy. You could also call me maybe. You could also call me Carly Rae Jepsen. I won't answer to any of those things, but you could call me that. So what to serve? This is the continent bonus then. Recruits cost 10 supplies. That seems not hugely useful. I mean, recruits basically seem free. Like, we can go get recruits, it seems like, anytime we want.
Strategic resource.
Oh, sweet. Located. Service deploy. Okay, so in the shell of bomb, service deploy aircraft remains in this area. After many hours, we were able to recover materials from inside a structure. Fantastic. I don't want to fly back to Resistance HQ yet, do I? I would actually rather make contact if we could. We got supplies. You know what I want to do? I want to build a friggin' battle scanner. While we got supplies, we're doing the battle scanner thing. The mine shield, if we had more, like, slots, like tactical rigging where we could take other stuff, I might consider it. But honestly, I think we're better off just having grenades for some more cover destruction. We definitely, definitely want a battle scanners, though. What's up? Can you build me a battle scanner here? Yeah, so instant build. Fantastic. Yeah, go ahead and do that. Sweet. Battle scanner is complete. I'm excited. I am happy. Thank you for your time, Miss Shen. I appreciate your service to the project. Please return to what you were doing. I'm sorry I cut you off there, but I went straight to the thing. I don't know what you were trying to say, but hopefully it wasn't any kind of mission critical shit, because if it was, I'm not gonna get it. Wait, we never finished making contact in Mexico? Alright, this Mexican thing has gotta happen. What is it that every alien service hates about the noble Mexican people? Why do you hate them so, aliens? What did they ever do to you? Alien debris is cleared. So 50 more supplies, and we can construct a facility. Alright, so let's view this room. The Proving Ground is our mission objective thing. Shen can test and produce new, unique types of ammo, grenades, and armor for our soldiers, as well as other specialized tech. I mean, that seems really good. A laboratory also seems useful. Oh, no, we have to staff a scientist in a laboratory to make it go... okay. Workshop. Engineers can be staffed in workshops, creating unique gremlin drones, which can be sent to staff any adjacent room or facility. That seems really, really good. Like, if we made this a workshop, whatever we put here, 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 and here, we could have one engineer staff all of them. That seems phenomenally useful. So, yeah, you know what? Let's do that. Let's come in here, and I think I'm gonna do it. I mean, we also need the Guerrilla Tactics School, but we're gonna need a power relay before we can get that. So I think what we should do, let's build a workshop. And we're not gonna assign an engineer to that. What we're instead gonna do is we're gonna have our engineer come up here and start excavating instead. I don't want her building the workshop. I want her beginning excavation. No, you're, yes, reassignment. Begin excavating, yes. Now I know that's gonna make the workshop take longer. It takes 20 days, but hopefully before that fully expires or completes, we can actually get maybe another engineer. Having one engineer in this, it seems like we're really kind of behind the eight ball. We're cornered like a starving rat. Why is it always rats that get cornered? I mean, other animals get cornered occasionally. You could corner a human, but you never hear, oh man, I've been cornered like a starving human. So we're down in Mexico. Hey, by the way, whoever's down here, maybe consider picking up a few crates of tequila for Bradford. If you go to Mexico and come back without at least a souvenir bottle of tequila for Bradford, he's going to be real pissed off. So consider souvenir, bottle, Bradford, with the yes and the bringing home. Complete the Advent Black Site mission. Tell me more. This didn't tell me any more at all. Access the alien network. Investigate the Advent Black Site. Examine an Advent. Okay, so I don't really want to try this Black Site mission because that seems really hard. And what I'd like to do before we go try anything that seems supremely difficult is get a fifth squad member. I really kind of feel like we need a fifth squaddy. So, yeah, okay. Am I gonna do it? With the local resistance and we're ready to move on the alien black side on your order. Well, that's nice, but I'm not giving that order yet because I want another guy, but are we going to be able to afford to delay that long to get another guy, though? That's the question. We may not be able to delay that long. Because we would have to build the project center, get somebody promoted to... I'm guessing we probably have to have a sergeant, too. Because there was, in the previous version, there was like a minimum requirement in order for us to... maybe we try this black site mission. I mean, it wouldn't have us do this if we were going to be just woefully outgunned, right? We got to three amigos. Let's do it. I say we go for it. Let's try it. We got battle scanners now too, which seem supremely useful. Magnetic weapons are 8 days. Yeah, a supply drop and let's do it. Let's try this black site mission. They wouldn't. I kind of feel like they wouldn't recommend that we do this if we weren't capable of doing it. Or this is a trap and Admiral Akbar somewhere is right now having a complete apoplectic fit and I'm about to walk into a meat grinder. But either way, it should at least be interesting. So let's do it. Do we take the best team we could possibly field? I think the answer to that is definitively yeah. We're going to need every scrap of what we can get. So we're taking the best that we got. We're going with the nanoscale vest for Dina Meyer. I think we got to hang on to the med kit. Seems fine. Ace. You're taking a battle scanner. That grenade you have has never proven useful because you're so far away from things. Being a squad site sniper, you're ever unlikely to throw it. Non-zero chance you might throw a battle scanner, and I do love me some battle scanners. So let's do this. UMI kids, I want some bugs. Eat them for breakfast. I guess. I mean, there's eggs, but whatever. If you're set on bugs, fuck it. Knock yourself out. I don't care what you eat. I'm gonna have scrambled eggs. I mean, we've got plenty of powdered eggs and milk, and we can make scrambled eggs, guys. It'd be fine. But if you want to eat bugs, fuck it. It's all the new rave. I'm sure we'll all be eating bugs in 25 years from now. Well, I won't. I'll probably be dead, and that's fine because I don't want to have to eat bugs. The rest of y'all, you younger generation, though, hey, look forward to a little cricket soup. It's gonna be delicious. Maybe a little like a grasshopper gazpacho. Sounds fantastic. I don't know why insects can only be made into soups, but that's just the way it works in my head. Operation Iron Days. Yeah, sounds all right. In the wilderness of New Mexico. Holy shit, for once Bradford has identified a location on the globe as somewhere other than Kansas City. I'm speechless. So this trip has taken a long time, guys. I mean, we went from... Wait, we went from Mexico to Mexico. Why is this flight taking so long? Are we detouring through, like, France? What's the scoop here? We went from, like, central Mexico, say, Mexico City, to, like Tijuana, sort of, in that region. I mean, we're, like, just south of the border. We're in, like, a Corpus Christi kind of area. Maybe that's a new thing. In XCOM 2, flights happen in real time. It actually takes as long to fly there. It was ordinarily take if you were literally on a plane. It's like a new immersion tactic. Be like, no, if it's 5 hours of flight time, it takes 5 hours of game time to actually fly there. That would be a funny mechanic, but a terrible one. They dropped us off on a rooftop. I am a fan of this, especially considering we have Jake Busey on our side. So we're supposed to go to this place. Expect heavy resistance, neutralize all hostile contacts. Get to the evac point. Do we have a time limit? We're concealed. Do we have a time limit? It does not appear that we have a time limit. So just kill... Okay, well, this is my kind of mission. The mission is basically just go kill everything. That's the kind of thing I can get behind. We've got an enemy squad here. Okay, so we've got an advent officer and an advent trooper and also a turret. I don't like the... Wait, is that a turret? Maybe it's not. I mean, it looks like... Maybe it doesn't become active until... I'm torn. I do like the fact that we could shoot these guys, but the rest of the team is really far away. If we have Jake Busey... I mean, he's got a really good shot, even with his pistol. We're not gonna have him shoot a pistol. That's just... I mean, that's foolish. So we do need to avoid detection. We have detection tiles over here. I'm guessing these are from the guys... Let's see if we can just straight up, like, drop a big ol' ambush on their heads from this rooftop. I like that plan. I'm excited to be a part of it. I'm just excited to be playing not The Long War, honestly. I mean, The Long War was a great game, but I played a real lot of The Long War. And XCOM 2, it's real good. It's an amazing game. If you haven't picked up a copy, very seriously consider it, because it's February, and I'm pretty sure this is already my game of the year pick. So you're going to be on Overwatch. Oh, shit. He won't automatically shoot if we... Because we're... Oh, he won't blow my concealment for a terrible Overwatch shot, will he? Do we... We don't take Overwatch if we're concealed. Please tell me that's a mechanic that they... Okay. Whew. So we can't see those guys anywhere. But we did see a guy down here a second ago. If we run to the edge of that ledge, are we going to just trip... Really don't want to do that. All right, Dina Meyer, we're gonna move you to here. Watch out for the pigeons. Don't scare the pigeons, man. They didn't hurt anybody. They're just there trying to feed. Don't bother the pigeons. Casper, you can double move. That's fine. Busey, I really, you know what? We're just gonna have you. You're gonna just sprint up. Michael Ironside, we're gonna bring you over here. And then we're just going to have Jake Busey play catch-up, because Jake may be, like, from the top of this building, he should be able to do a whole lot of good stuff for us. He should be able to throw some... Oh, my God, please tell me you did not just take the stupidest path in it. I really got to start using the pathing mechanic. I'm so used to playing vanilla XCOM that it just, most of the time, it never even crosses my mind, but I really, really need to start focusing on that. What the fuck is that?
Operating under the guise of thin men.
Okay.
Now show their true form, a purely reptilian species.
Well, now we know what John Lennon looks like when he's not wearing his meat suit. And I gotta say, it's pretty fucking horrible. So we can see those guys, right? Yes, we can. We actually have a really good chance of hitting both of them. Do we want to blow our concealment, or... Do we do it the smart way? You know what? I think we got to try and do this the smart way. This is not a detection tile, right? Okay, it says it's not a detection tile. Let's test this theory. Not detected. Beautiful. Okay, so we got to try and set up an ambush here. We're going to bring Jake Busey, this corner cover. I want to make sure Busey can see both of them, because if he can't, he's got to move. Okay, he can. Good. Dina Meyer, we're going to bring you up here. Honestly, in this situation, you're a little less important because, unfortunately, your shotgun is not going to be supremely well-suited for this kind of work. But Casper Van Dien, we're going to bring you up here. Next turn, I have a pretty, what I think at least, is a pretty solid plan. You're going to overwatch. Busey, overwatch. Just everybody overwatch. And you're probably going to be overwatching next turn as well. Because I do have a... Okay, these guys stay out in the open. And stay in sight. Stay in the open and stay in sight. Okay, I hear movement to my left as well. Okay, is that Snake Man still visible? Snake Man is totally still visible, and we have a great chance of ruining his shit. Alright, let's make with the shit ruining then. So, Dina Meyer, can you get a little... Oh, you can get a little... We want Dina Meyer to be closer, if at all possible, but we also want her to be on Overwatch. Maybe that's too close, because I heard movement to my left. If there's guys over there, I don't want to risk a chance that Dina Meyer gets spotted. So let's make her get a little bit closer, but let's not go insane. My goal is to just have everybody be on Overwatch, have Jake Busey shoot, and then while these guys are out in the open, just tear them apart. What are our hit percentages like? Really good? Casper Van Dien, what's your hit percentage like? Really good. Alright, and then we're gonna have Busey just ruin this guy. Alright, kill this Viper. If you could crit him, that'd be amazing. What the fuck is dodge? Excuse me, XCOM? What the hell is that? Why did that do 2 damage? Okay, I'm more than a little salty about that. What is that? That should have been a dead guy. Well, Casper Van Dien missed. Michael Ironside did 3 damage, and... Okay, well, Dina Meyer blew him in half. Alright, well, my Overwatch trick was surprisingly effective. I mean, that worked really well. I really don't like whatever the shit dodge is, though, because that ability seems like total horseshit. A 95% chance to hit with a sniper shot, and what did we get out of it? We got 2 friggin' damage out of it. That's what we got. What are you doing? They're taking a terrible shot at Dina Meyer, but if you can see her, that means she can see you, so she's gonna hunt down... She's just gonna probably jump down and shotgun your ass next turn. Will we need to do anything else? What's your shot like from here? Pretty good. Honestly, I'd rather go for the slam dunk. We're gonna have Dina hop down. This is a flank shot. This should be literally can't miss. Yeah, 100%. The minimum damage kills him. And we blew him right to shit in half. Nice work, Dina. Yeah, he was with extreme prejudice eliminated. So, Michael Ironside, let's bring you up here. Because I heard movement over here. If there are enemies... What? Are there bad guys? Nope. Yeah. You know, Bradford, why are you surprised? They were doing this before, and arguably you survived it, so why the confusion? You should just go, oh yeah, it's the alien things. They throw you in those and then they take you. That's their abduction thing. It's fine, it's just an abduction pod. Really nothing to concern yourself with. So let's get Jake Busey to this corner cover. I don't like that it's a dash. I would like to have Jake reload. Oh, shit. Well, that's terrible. Oh, this guy's coming straight up at us? What the shit? Alright, well, Michael Ironside is it's an advent officer, too, and Michael Ironside has a terrible chance to hit him. Well, this seems like a problem for Casper Van Dien to solve, honestly. So let's just do this. And worst case scenario, we eradicate this guy's cover. Best case scenario, this blows a hole in the floor and he dies from fall damage? I mean, fall damage, have a nice trip. We just got an achievement, so did we just kill a man with fall damage? Did he die? Yep. Oh, Ace is in a fairly precarious position as a result, though. Michael Ironside can't really do anything. He's in full cover. How are you flanked, Ironside? What has you flanked? Wait, I'm confused. Why are you flanked? You're in full cover. What's going on? Why? How are you flanked? You are flanked. Ace is not flanked. He's just in half cover. Why is he showing up as flanked? Neither of those guys should be flanking Michael Ironside. Actually, neither of those guys can even see Michael Ironside, because if they could see him, theoretically, he should be able to see them, too. We could either overwatch or aid protocol. I think aid protocoling Jake Busey in half cover is probably more useful. Let's go that route. I'm going to assume that this shield just didn't change when that guy died. Because he did have... Okay, yep, that's exactly what happened. For whatever reason, when the guy died from the fall damage, it didn't update. Oh, shit. Is that a shock trooper? Oh, piss. That's a shock trooper. That would hurt a little. Stunned. What is stunned? Okay, so this is another new mechanic. Man, these guys are real brazen. They're just straight up bum rushing us. Maybe we should have concentrated on the stun lancer then? This is fucking horrible. So Jake Busey just straight up killed. I really don't know what I could have possibly done about that. I mean, maybe not triggered the pod. You're saying, you know, you shouldn't have triggered the pod, Pete. And maybe you're not wrong. Wow, that... Alright, well, there goes Jake Ace Busey. Dina Meyer is not going to be able to contribute a single fucking thing here, is she? She could move to the corner and maybe get a shotgun shot at this other guy. She can't even see him. Yeah, I'm a little busy, Bradford. I'm not worried about the fucking extent of Advent's goddamn rail network at the moment. I'm more curious about this stun lancer who's gonna come up and rip my shit apart. Or at least he would have until Casper Van Dien put a bullet in his face. Dina Meyer also could use a reload. Let's put her on. You can suddenly see this guy. Suddenly see him. And we're going on Overwatch. Man, I'm real salty about the death of old Ace there. You know, the other thing wait, is he dead? I'm confused. Why can we carry him? Is he dead or not? Pick up the target and carry them with you. If he's dead, why would I want to carry him? He's dead, right? Man, I guess I should have been paying a little more attention. I would love... Can we get a flank shot at that guy? Maybe, but that's no cover whatsoever. Every time I have tried this, it has also not worked out. I was thinking about just going brazen, going for the flank shot, and trying to straight up kill him with Michael Ironside. Every time I try this, though, it does 3 damage. Screw it. Things are already going really bad. We might as well... I mean, when the ship is sinking, what the hell's the point in bailing? If the ship is sinking, we might as well fucking just throw rocks at everything. Give me your 3 damage here, Michael Ironside. Or just fucking straight up miss. That's brilliant. Alright, well, this just went from bad to goddamn abominable. And I'm thinking about maybe just bailing out. I don't know how we're going to win this with only 3 guys. Dina Meyer's probably going to save the day. I was going to say save the day. Dina Meyer's probably going to save the day. She absolutely saved the day. So is Jake Busey dead or not? If he's dead, why can I carry him? I don't understand what advantage carrying a dead person has. Do we have to carry him to get his stuff? Is that how it works? We have to carry him in order to recover his shit, don't we? Brilliant. Yeah, launch a frag grenade on top of your own position. That's perfect. Also, if anybody's carrying this guy, it needs to not be Casper Van Dien. So let's have you drop him, please. Understood. Moving out. I guess we can't do that in the same turn. That's fine. Dizzy, come up here and just be on Overwatch for us. Please tell me you just did not pop another pod, Dizzy. Good, I was going to be real salty if you had popped another pod. What the hell is that thing? Um, What was that? It looked really ominous. Was that a fucking sectopod? If they sent me in to fight a goddamn sectopod, I'm gonna be unspeakably salty. We are definitely not equipped to fight a sectopod. Dizzy, you're on Overwatch. Wow, I really feel like we may have been trapped on this one. Can we just straight up evac? If that's a sectopod, we should run. We just are not geared to fight that sort of thing. We have three guys here. We're not going to be able to beat it. I'd love to throw a battle scanner up there and see if it is in fact a sectopod, but there's no way for us to do that. Also, we're not really going to have... I mean, we're not even going to be full fighting trim, because theoretically somebody's going to be carrying a dead man. Maybe we just say to hell with it and leave the battle scanner. Or maybe we just say to hell with the mission altogether and leave, period. Or maybe this is where the entire campaign just fucking falls apart. We have to go through this door? It looks like yes, we have to go through the door. Alright, well, we're not doing any of this until everybody catches up. So, Casper, I want you to come up here and I want you to drop your little buddy.
I'm Jake Busey. They call me the dead guy. I'm a puppet. I'm the dead puppet.
Also, you need to reload, so drop him. Does dropping him still take our action? Oh, yeah, be real gentle with him. I mean, he's fucking corpse. At this point, he's a sack of meat. You could toss him around like an old used bag of trash. It's not like he's gonna feel it.
On the move.
He's very definitely dead. Well, we could certainly use a sniper to help us pick that guy off, couldn't we? Is that thing active? It is. We can't see it. It can't see us. It does take an action to pick up or drop a corpse. Does he have any gear that's not replaceable? Just a battle scanner. A battle scanner is 30 supplies. You know what? We're leaving it. I'm gonna feel real bad if he's not dead, though. Dina Meyer, you need to reload. We can't run into this with anybody having less than a 100% full clip. Michael Ironside, you reload.
Back in.
I gotta say, I feel like our medic is not ever really helping. Because our troopers don't ever seem to actually get injured. They just seem to get killed. You gotta be shitting me. That guy can see us? We can't see him. How is it shooting us? I really want to know how that thing is shooting at me. I can't see it, but it can see me and shoot at me. It doesn't have a spotter, so it's not like it's getting squad sight or anything. These non-transparent mechanics really make me angry.
Roll it out.
Also, Casper Van Dien does not have any bullets at all. We're going to be charging into this fight, and he's going to have literally one shot in the chamber. Fantastic. Okay, this mission is a nightmare. We found our first, whatever that Viper, I guess they're called now. We found our first non-disguised thin man. This thing apparently just doesn't ever miss, even guys in total full cover at extreme ranges. And Casper Van Dien has panicked. Well, he's gonna fucking die now, aren't you? Well, he did some damage to it. I don't think anybody else is gonna be able to get line of sight on the turret in order to shoot it, though. And now we're panicked. So can you get up? No, of course not. Dizzy, can you go hit it with a sword? Nope. So Casper Van Dien is probably also dead then, right? Alright, so I guess our one defense is going to be just don't be in line of sight of the thing. Meanwhile, Casper Van Dien is going to get picked apart by... Never mind, we're all going to die. There is no safety. So we bring Dina Meyer to here. We try to have her open the door. Do we have to kill everything, or can we just, like, do the mission and leave? Can we just, like... Because if that's the case, we didn't need to fight any of this stuff. We could have just stealthed it all. Like, we could have just tried to stay concealed through the entire mission, which seems like it would have been way smarter.
Roger that.
Or am I just the world's dumb... What the fuck now? This mission is going terribly. I think every single one of our soldiers here is about to die. Casper Van Dien is definitely dead. Don't get your hopes up, Bradford. I hate to burst your bubble here, but that is probably not going to happen. We're actually fully running away from the enemy as we speak. So this is going terrifically badly. He can spit poison through walls? Goddamn, Vipers are broken amazing. There's no way it had line of sight on us. Absolutely no way. Casper Van Dien's just gonna get killed. No, but his cover is destroyed. We've got to get out of line of sight of that turret. Casper Van Dien is no longer poisoned. There's no longer panic. Dina Meyer is still poisoned. Dina Meyer is panicked. Well, you're dead then, aren't you? Fantastic shot. So panic is still a thing that is completely and totally atrocious. Like, if you get panicked, you might as well just kiss your ass goodbye. Casper Van Dien has no bullets. Because why would he? Is there anything we can do to not die here? No? Can we call the... Ability unavailable. Well, that's great.
Good copy. Moving on target.
So I guess we just have to be consigned with the fact that everybody's gonna die. The only other thing we could do is, like, open this door and try to run to a place where we can maybe put up some kind of defensive perimeter. I thought that was going to be full cover. That was decidedly not full cover. Everybody dies. We're done. This is sunk. Wow, I had no business coming on this mission. Like, literally none at all. This is way, way too hard for our skill level. Our troops' abilities. We don't have the soup to do this mission. To have it encourage me to do this... This is just, like, cheap bullshittery trickery gameplay right here. To try and... man, I really feel like maybe this run is already doomed. I'm not sure we're going to be able to rebuild. The rest of our team is, like, basically all rookies. This is a squad wipe. There's no way we get out of this alive. No possible combination of moves that allows us to even have a remote chance of survival. I mean, Casper Van Dien is absolutely dead. Dina Meyer is panicked and absolutely dead. We might be able to get Michael Ironside out of it, maybe. If we skip the objective and just run straight to the evac zone. Who earned a promotion? So you're dead. What the fuck is that? It pulled him out of cover. And into poison. Oh, that's just evil. Michael Ironside managed to keep himself a safe. Casper Van Dien is poisoned. Man, pulling him out of cover and into poison, that's just bullshit and trickery right there. Especially considering you did it through a fucking wall. Why do all of the Viper's abilities work through walls? You're stunned and critical. Everybody's dead. That's it. This entire team is destroyed. We had no business whatsoever coming on this mission. Just none. We're so badly outgunned right now, it's not even funny. We need at least five guys for this. Actually, we need five relatively high-level guys for this. We had no business even trying this mission. Michael Ironside is dead. Jake Busey is dead. Michael Ironside is dead. Man, this just completely came off the rails. We have no chance of survival here. Just none. I'm gonna make my time. We have no chance to survive. Wow. This is really kind of cheap, actually, that they would just sort of trick us into doing this mission. Don't give me, like, objective missions and tell me, oh, this is a priority, when I have literally zero chance of potential success. Dina Meyer is still panicked. Casper Van Dien is poisoned and has no bullets in his gun. And is panicked. Just fucking kill me already then, alien. Stop fucking around. Put the goddamn knife in. Stop twisting it. Just cut my throat. Sure, go for the strangle. Well, I mean, bound. We have no idea what that did. Vipers are just ridiculous. And Dina Meyer is... Okay, so that's end of mission then. Fantastic. We had no business coming on that mission. There are 16 enemies on that mission. We have absolutely no business doing that. Absolutely none. All right, well, I mean, important lesson learned, I guess, which is don't try Operation Iron Days because you'll get completely butt-fucked. Wow. I mean, they said a hard mission, but they didn't say just entirely out of your league. Prepare for a mission in which you will be 100% supremely overwhelmed. Because that's what that mission was. 16 enemies with four corporals. You give me the opportunity to try and kill 16 guys with four corporals. That's just mean. Man, I think, wow. You know what? I think we may have to run this again. We have to start over. Let's go take a look at the base and see if this one is going to be recoverable or if that was just a death knell. That mission is not beatable this early in the campaign. We do not have enough damage or enough... Really, we just don't have enough soldiers. Sky Ranger's okay, though. Got that going for us. Hey, everybody, look, Sky Ranger's back. Let's go take a look at our roster and see what we have available. We have to do something to help our troops? Well, how about not just fucking send us in just so far over our heads that it's not even funny? Casper Van Dien, Jake Busey, I mean, we've basically killed all of the Starship Troopers at this point. Except for Denise Nuclear Richards. She was a nuclear scientist. I think this one may have come off the rails. And that's the thing, is we didn't play bad tactically. How many troopers did we lose? What, two, I think, that weren't scripted? One who blew himself up with a grenade taught us an important lesson. Amy Smart, who honestly deserved to die. And then this, where everything just completely fell apart. And this is such an early crushing blow to the project that I honestly don't even want to try to recover it. Supplies are used to purchase. Yeah, I know. We don't have enough supplies. Sell items at the black market. We don't even establish contact. Yeah, thank you. Attention, low supplies. I appreciate it. Everyone is dead. Does that take away our stuff? Let's go take a look. Build items. We absolutely lose everything we had equipped. So we have no med kit, we have no battle scanner. Brilliant. The nanoscale vest, alright, do you have to bring back the troopers or you lose their stuff? I mean, that's fair. Let's go look at the armory. We have any supplies do we even have? Dad would have been proud of what we're doing here. Really? I think you would have been ashamed and also terrified because I'm pretty sure this just ended our campaign. I think this one is over. We may just have to pull a full restart. Wow. Okay, so we had no business at all whatsoever going. My salt is becoming very crystalline and pure and bitter and grainy because that really seems like cheap trickery. For your first campaign playthrough to say, oh, hey, go try and do this Advent Black Site. It shouldn't recommend that you do that when you have absolutely no chance of doing it. That's like saying, oh, you know, you got like what, a sergeant, two corporals, and a squaddy? Ah, you're fine. Go assault the temple ship. You'll be okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm speechlessly salty. My mouth is caked and caked with salt. Just go to the armory so I can see what kind of soldiers we have here. So we have a gravely wounded corporal, Patrick Muldoon. We have a squaddy grenadier. We have a squaddy sharpshooter. And four rookies. One of them is gravely wounded, and I don't think we can rebuild this. And it's not that I don't want to try and rebuild, it's just that it's so early in the campaign, it feels kind of pointless to make an effort when we could just restart it. And learn a valuable lesson, which is don't do any kind of mission priority stuff until you have a supremely powerful team. That really feels like, I mean, it's just a wicked kick right in the nuts. If we had supplies, maybe we could try and rally this around, maybe? But you know what? I think we're probably just going to have to do a full restart. So I've got a little off-camera grinding to do. That'll be fun. We'll go do that off-camera, and I guess we'll wrap this one up. Man, I am very bitter about this. You should have at least given me an Admiral Ackbar, it's a trap warning, or something. You could have tossed me a bone here. Anyway, That's going to be it for this one. We'll be back again, of course, because while we may be defeated, we lost this battle, yes, but the war is not over. We were doing fine on a tactical map, so I really don't feel like we were until that happened. And then if we were further along in a campaign, I would continue to try to rebuild. But this early, I think it's probably best to just restart. And that's what I'm going to do. But right now, this one's done. I really need to take a break for a minute. If you enjoyed the episode, feel free to drop a like down in the comments section. Of course, your support does really mean a lot to us. And if you'd like to see more cataclysmic failures, you might consider subscribing as well. Post new episodes of XCOM every single day. Right now, however, I'm going to go softly weep for the MI kids who have fallen at the big K. But, you know, that's it. Every mobile infantry has their big K. The mobile infantry lost on Klindathu as well, but they came back. And you know what? We're coming back as well. Probably with the same team, but we're coming back. We can do it. Thanks very much for watching. I'll see you again soon.